My name is Milda Motskonyte and I'm CPL holder. Today I'll try to fly an Airbus A320 for my first time. And today the first pilots will be incapable to land an aircraft and I'll have to take over the procedures. The first officer will give me instructions for landing an aircraft, and this will be an autopilot landing.
Okay, so we're gonna descend to 9000 and the plane should stop and 9000 continue. And it's stopping. We don't need to touch the yoke.
Yeah.
The plane is doing everything by itself. And you can see on my map display the approach plot. So we'll be turning left, then right, and then left again on the final for 25 left. Yep. Okay, try to lower the altitude from 9000, you can see on the pilot, to 4000. Try to turn the altitude.
Yeah,
now.
Absolutely.
4000.
Yeah,
4000. Okay. And we are turning left. We should also turn all the lights so the other planes could see us, because we have adverse weather conditions. The light buttons are on the overhead panel on the lower half. You can see strobe lights, beacon lights, wing lights, and so on. Below them will be landing lights. They are now on. And runway turn-off lights. Turn them on also. This one, yeah. No, the one below. Uh-huh.
Yeah.
This, and on the right side, nose lights. To take off. Okay. Good. Okay, and we're turning right again. Now, before we get to the level, I will tell you what to do when we approach the airport.
Yeah,
so we'll use the flaps lever. It is on the lower half on the right, on the left side is speed brake, and on the right side is flaps. Yeah. So we'll set the flaps, but later, not now, but later, we'll set flaps to 1, 2, 3 and pull them. To set the flaps, you have to pull the lower left half like you would on the car gear shifted. Pull it and set it to 1, 2, 3 and 4.
Sure.
The gear lever is there. Yeah, this is the gear level, so we'll lower it. On the top of the gear level, higher there is the auto brake. You can, there is low, medium and maximum auto brake. You can push the medium one to on. Can you see it? Above the landing gear, above the clock.
Yeah.
Above the clock, auto brake. Yeah, so push the middle button, medium, this one, push it.
Yeah, sure.
Push it now.
Yeah.
Okay.
It's on.
On. Okay, we should get to lower altitude. The altitude knob, pull it. Pull the knob. Okay, good. That's it. Now the plane will start to descend to 4,000. And we should set the pressure. In front of you on the autopilot panel you see STD, standard, written on the left side there, on the screen, on the little screen on the left. Just fire this
here?
One, yeah.
Sure.
Rotate it. Rotate the knob. Rotate it.
Yeah.
Just rotate it.
To the right?
Yeah. Or just try to pull it. And try to push it. Now set it 1010.
1010.
And the same on the right side, and don't push it. Don't just leave it, and the same on the right side.
1010.
Yeah. Okay.
Yeah.
So we now have the local pressure. Okay, and we'll now try turn to the left onto the final. So you have to lower the speed. The speed is also on the autopilot. It's now 250.
Yeah.
You see the speed? Rotate it to 190.
190.
190.
Oh,
and leave it like this. Okay. There is also an ILS button below the barometric pressure button.
Yeah.
ILS, yeah, push this one.
Yep.
And on my side also, on the right side also. Okay. And the speed now disconnected. Pull the speed button. Pull it. Good. Okay, so on the main display, primary display, you can see the ILS, the localizer below that, below the display, and the glide slope on the right, So we have the localizer. I have to push the localizer button on the console, on the autopilot. You will see just below the speed knob, localizer button.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, this one, push it. Good.
Set.
And we are turning on to the final. We have about 26 miles to the runway, more than enough time to do this correctly. Okay, localizer is now captured. So we just continue. And we also now have the glide slope. So when you have to push the approach button, it's also on the console, on the right side of the console of the autopilot. No, this is autopilot, more on the right. Yeah, the approach.
Approach button.
Good. And localizer is captured, glide slope is armed. Okay, we should also arm the spoilers. So the spoilers handle is on the left side, where the flaps handle is.
Yeah.
This flaps spoilers on the left. This one, yeah. Pull it to you. Yeah, good. Now they are armed and we'll deploy when we land. You can see on the middle monitor, ground spoilers armed, written on the middle one. In the middle, you can see ground spoilers armed and seatbelts no smoking. So if everything is okay. Okay, so now set flaps to 1.
To 1?
Yeah.
Flaps 1?
Yeah, good. We will automatically slow some more. Okay, we have 20 miles to the runway. I can see it. We have 5 kilometers visibility, so let's hope the autopilot does the job correctly. And we wait for the glide slope to start to move, and that should happen in around 6 or 7 miles. Then we will set the gear down and set flaps to 2 when the glide slope starts to move. Okay, the glide slope is now moving,
yes.
So lower the gear, pull it and down.
Gear down.
Good. Gear is down. We have the gear down, lights, and now flaps 2.
Flaps 2?
Yeah. Slope is captured. We will now start descending towards the airport. We still have 10 miles to go. So now flaps to full. Flaps,
flaps
to 3 and then to full. Full.
Set.
Good. Now turn on the second autopilot. So now autopilot 1 is on, you can see the light. Next to it is autopilot 2. Press that. Okay, so both autopilots are on. And it will be on the auto land. Okay, 6 miles to the runway. Emergency services are notified and we are clear to land. Now, when we will be nearing the runway, it will be 1000 feet, 500 and then 150. And then the plane will call retard. Retard, that means that you have to pull the throttle back. So we have the throttle handles in the middle. In the middle, the throttle handles, the black ones, yeah, these ones. They're now in automatic position in climb mode. When I will tell you, you have to what the airplane says them, retard them, so pull them back, okay?
Yeah.
And if something happens and we have to go around, you have the red button on the joystick there. You have the red button, don't press it now.
Yeah.
And also red button on the throttle. Two red buttons. So if something happens, you have to press the red button and just pull up. Okay, so we have 2,000 feet left. So we have the checklist in the middle, on the middle monitor, landing checklist. So landing gear is down, signs are on, cabin ready, spoilers on, flaps full. No notifications, so we are fully configured and ready to plan. Can you see the runway?
Runway in sight.
Okay.
500.
And now the plane is in land mode, so it should roll out itself. Just wait for the retouch out and pull the throttle down.
200.
200. And stop. Pull the parking brake, it's below the flaps lever. This one, pull it and set it on. Pull it and turn to right on. And that's it. Yeah. Good job.
To land an Airbus A320 was quite easy with an autopilot. And it was really nice touchdown. It was a lot of fun, and thank you for watching this video, and I'll see you next time.